challenge. I like the variety. All day, every day is different. I like the freedom. There's no one breathing over my shoulder.
I learned not to care what anybody else thought about me. I learned that I could rise to an occasion. I learned that the world's a big, exciting, beautiful place, and most people are good.
Johanna Wilson, then and now. Those old images are from 1978 and those truck driving days when she was 29. Now, she's 73, and almost 50 years later, I learned the rest of her life's story.
I wanted to see more of the world, and when you and I met, I'd had about a year-long plan to hitchhike around the world. First, I took a year off to hitchhike around America and say goodbye to all my favorite places and my favorite people.
With that done, it was off to Mexico.
Took me a year and a half to backpack and hitchhike through Mexico.
In Mexico, she remembered a story she read in high school about a man taking in orphaned boys.
But I finally got to visit the orphanage, and I've been deeply involved since then. Sometimes I go down for overnight for Christmas, sometimes 9 months at a time to volunteer as a house mother. I've served on the board for about 30 years. I just resigned from the board about 3 years ago. We don't accept any government money, any church money. It's all just word of mouth, and it's been going on for a lot more than 50 years now.
Still in Mexico, the ocean called, and she made plans for two trips on a sailboat to Hawaii.
Taught myself celestial navigation, taught myself Polynesian navigation, and that's what the little sailboat I was on was 30 feet. And the skipper let me use a spare sextant. And we used my navigation and my Polynesian navigation to get us through the gates of the harbor at Hilo, Hawaii. One of my proudest achievements, because I'm not a math person.
Another trip to Hawaii via sailboat almost ended in disaster when they met a hurricane.
And we went through the day, and that night, we were sinking. And by the grace of that skipper, it was just him and me, but he was able to get that sailboat turned around, and it was like being in a washing machine, and he'd go up and see where the next waves were coming from until he was finally able to surf up one wave, let another one hit our tail, turn us around and surf down that wave and try to get back to land. We did. We were able to circle around outside the harbor. We spent quite a bit of time rebuilding that boat. She had a big hole in her side. We were sinking. What I learned then is, if you're breathing, you can take it from there.
Rebuilding that boat could have been a metaphor for her life. Earlier, while she was driving that semi, she knew eventually she would need more education.
It took me about 20 years to get my education because I was traveling so much. I've been to 8 different universities and start at the bottom every time. Got the equivalent of a master's in teaching English to speakers of other languages. Was lucky to be brought on to the faculty as an adjunct professor at the University of Utah. Really loved working with the refugees and the immigrants at night.
But there was even more travel in her life.
Oh, I know, Alaska. Oh, Alaska, yeah. It went up there in one of those old cracker box Honda Civics, the little short ones, and slept in the back of it, went up and camped in the winter, got a job at Denali National Park, and then got a job with the Flight Scene Service, got a job that takes mountain climbers up to the mountain. Oh, Alaska. Everybody needs to go to Alaska before they die.
Talk about a variety of adventures.
Teaching Stone Age Survival School, loved it. This was in southern Utah, in the last little bit of America to be mapped. Meeting the people that signed up for this course on purpose, and it lasted a month. It's the best thing I've done in my life. And the thing I learned from that, Larry, was that we're all in this together. Nobody gets there till we all get there.
Coming back to Wichita in 2000 to take care of elderly parents, she endured another adventure, but not of her choice.
But I was diagnosed almost 20 years ago with a cancer so aggressive that they had nothing for me. and were just going to give me comfort care to the end.
But her oncologist found a breakthrough study that he thought might help her. But to qualify, Johanna had to go through rounds of the most aggressive chemotherapy.
People said, oh, you're going to lose your hair. Well, I lost my hair. I lost my fingernails and toenails, all the skin on my hands and feet. It was a mess. But what I learned is how many good people there are. What I learned is what you can endure. The trial drug saved my life. I have had no sign of cancer for 20 years now. And every year is a gift, and every day is a gift. A lot of people know that. I was lucky to learn it too.
And as if her life wasn't unusual enough, at East High School, she dated this guy, Gordon Brown.
I say courting. He says dating in high school. Vietnam came along. We didn't mesh anymore. I had plans that he didn't want to participate in. And he dropped me like a hot potato. Broke my heart. I carried a torch for him for 50 years.
And then, a few years ago, Johanna answered the phone at her home in Utah. It was Gordon.
We started traveling back and forth between his house here in Wichita, my house in the wilderness in Utah, for a good 3 years. And I finally sold my house. I left paradise. But he's worth paradise. Good man. Easy to live with, and I'm not. I got lucky.
In my 1978 story with Johanna, her life was exceptional then, full of dreams and unfulfilled adventures. I asked her why then that was important.
Johanna says simply, when I get old, I want to be able to say that I had the world at my fingertips and I didn't let it slip through.
If you got a dream in life, do it to it. You can't do worse than fail. That's it.
I just got lucky that I was rebellious enough to follow my heart.
Would you believe?